exposed. Exposed. Exposed.
You're exposed. You're exposed. You are exposed. 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 You are exposed, sir. I'm gonna expose you. Expose you. Oh my god, expose you.
A few months ago now, you guys probably remember Nikki Tutorials coming out on her YouTube channel as transgender.
Truly free. When I was younger, I was born in the wrong body, which means that I am transgender.
Her video currently sits at over 34 million views and has been the talk of the internet for months now. Nikki receives so much positive feedback and support from her video that news stations both in the Netherlands, where Nikki is from, and across the entire world were trying to get an interview with her. On January 20th, 2020, Nikki announced she was on her way to the airport to film with The Ellen Show. She wrote, "I cannot believe I'm about to say this, but I'm at the airport off to Los Angeles because I'll be a guest on The Ellen Show." It's clear that Nikki was really excited for the opportunity to be on a massive show like Ellen, although a lot of her fans weren't as excited for her. Some fans pointed out that it was strange that Ellen only wanted Nikki on her show now that she came out as transgender and was currently a really hot topic online, when Nikki's been a famous makeup artist for years. One fan wrote, "I love you, Nikki, and I'm proud of you, but don't you think it's weird that she wants you on the show days after you come out as trans? I wish Ellen would have asked you on the show earlier for your talent, and I still hope that she talks about that, not only you being trans." Although I will say, as someone who's watched Ellen for years now, she does have a segment on her show where she invites people who've had videos go viral online. Since Nikki's video pretty much went viral overnight, it makes a lot of sense that Ellen wanted her on the show. So Nikki jumped on a plane and flew off to California to meet Ellen. On her way to the studio, Nikki tweeted that she was actually shaking from being so excited, nervous, and pretty much everything in between. Nikki's episode aired like normal and everything seemed to be going great.
I remember uploading the video, I was like, oh, I gotta do it. And I started crying and my fiance Dylan was right next to me and he was like, you can do it.
She even posted a picture of herself and Ellen to Twitter after filming. Although I'm guessing during some point after filming, Nikki's excitement to meet Ellen quickly turned to major disappointment because Nikki went on a Dutch talk show back in February and spilled some tea about her experience with Ellen.
Hoe was het bij Ellen DeGeneres?
Nou, laat ik zeggen dat er een groot verschil is tussen De Wereld Draait Door en Ellen. En dan geef ik jullie het positieve handje.
Want?
Oh, punt.
Nou.
Nou, daar wil ik meer weten.
Nou ja, er zijn bepaalde... Kijk, bijvoorbeeld, het is wel heel leuk dat jij wel vooraf hallo komt zeggen en zo.
Ik kom vooraf hallo zeggen.
En we gaan door.
Hey, ik hoef helemaal niks over mijn Amerikaanse collega's. Ik ben alleen nieuwsgierig als dit Morris daar heel anders is dan
het
hier.
Het is bij Ellen in ieder geval, het is wat ik heb meegemaakt hier en andere landen, is dat gewoon een hele andere wereld. Het zit gewoon iets anders.
Afstandelijke killer.
Tikje.
Ellen was niet zo leuk.
Ellen was wel leuk, alleen het is heel anders van wat ik in Nederland heb ervaren.
Ja. Waar moesten we het doen? En,
ja, het is gewoon een andere structuur. En ik heb hier in Nederland in nogal wat shows gezeten, dus ik ben wat gewend. En dan als het iets anders is, dan is het niet per se slecht. Maar je denkt wel, oh, zo doen ze dat dan bij Ellen. Ja. En dat vind ik heel leuk dat ik het heb meegemaakt. Maar volgende keer ga ik gewoon weer ergens hier zitten, denk ik.
Ze heeft je geen hand meer gegeven na afloop bijvoorbeeld?
Nee. Nou ja.
So there you have it. Nikki traveled all the way across the globe to meet Ellen and to be on her show, and she couldn't even shake her hand after the show finished. This information couldn't have come at a more perfect time because just this past week, someone on Twitter created a thread asking people to share their horror stories working with Ellen. They wrote, "Right now, we all need a little kindness. You know, like Ellen DeGeneres always talks about, she's also notoriously one of the meanest people alive. Respond to this with the most insane stories you've heard about Ellen being mean, and I'll match everyone with a $2 donation to LA Food Bank." And oh my god, did this thread blow up. Tons of people replied under the thread with their stories of Ellen being the most amazing person that she wants everyone to believe that she is. Keep in mind that this is all allegedly, mainly because I really can't afford to be sued by someone that sells fitted sheets at Walmart for $70. Anyways, here's what people had to say about Ellen. When I was 15, The Ellen Show was doing a contest of fans making a bust of her and sending it to her. I worked so hard on this and even wrote her a letter. Weeks later, she used it as a prop in a game and gave it away to a random person with $500 attached to the bottom. An old friend worked on her lot and smiled and said good afternoon to her one day, and she became unhinged. "Who do you think you are? You don't look at me," yada yada. She said Portia was with her and seemed embarrassed and tried to calm her down. "My sister worked for The Ellen Show for 2 years. This is from her. I saw Ellen in the hallways every day and would say hello, and she never once said hello back. She wouldn't smile. She wouldn't even acknowledge me at all. For 2 seasons. I worked at Real Food Daily, served her and Portia at brunch. She brought a letter to the owner and complained about my chipped nail polish. Not that it was on her plate, but just that it was on my hand. I had worked till closing the night before, and this was the next morning. Almost got me fired. This person also has a clip from 2014 where they actually talked about the nail polish incident.
Until I was released after a really popular talk show host emailed the owner and complained about my chipped nail polish. True story. Not in her food, but on my hands.
The more and more you dig into Ellen, the more horror stories you find. For instance, back in 2008, Ellen offered Mariah Carey alcohol on stage to try and prove that she was pregnant. Mariah most likely didn't want people to know about her pregnancy because women typically wait until they're in a safe zone in case they have a miscarriage. Unfortunately, Mariah did end up having a miscarriage, and if Ellen never pushed her to pretty much announcing her pregnancy, no one would have known.